Hello everyone, welcome back to our second session all together. How was your break everyone? Did you enjoy during your break? I hope that the break was fun and you also didn't feel bored during your break. Now let's move back to our second session all together. And according to our schedule today, the second session you are going to learn about Grammar Galaxy 1, right? So today we are going to learn about a new unit, Unit 11. My friend can play the guitar. My friend can play the guitar. So the new unit today we focus on modal verb can and could, right? Modal verb. So you know modal verb? So you already learned some modal verbs already, right? And can and could. I think that you also have known about it for some point too. Now let's teacher explain you more about how to use can and could. So can we use? So we use can plus verb to talk about ability in the present. This means that we use it to talk about ability that in the present what you can do and can't not do. Alright, so we use could plus verb to talk about ability in the past. So two of them we use to talk about the ability the same, but different. Just one is in the present, another one is in the past, right? If you want to use can plus verb with ability, you just use can. But if you want to use past, you have your could plus verb to talk about the ability, right? All right, everyone. So now that I would like to tell you about the affirmative form only one form today. So subject plus can plus verb base plus object. So do you know verb base, right? So verb base we refer to verb that don't change form or pronunciation, right? All right. So subject plus can plus verb base, and some might say verb zero. Actually, we don't call this one as verb zero, we call it verb base, right? Alright, or we call it as bare infinitive, verb that we don't have to add S-E-S or change, even those we use in the past, present, future, and so on, we don't change form, we just still use as the original form, alright? And you can see object teacher put in the bracket, right? In the bracket. So when teacher put in the bracket here, it is mean that sometimes we use it, sometimes we don't use it. The sentence still correct. If we don't use the object, it's still a complete sentence, right? It's mean like this. That's what you put in the bracket. Like you can see now one. All right, I can swim in the pool today. So today here is the time is present in the prayer. In the present, right? So I can swim in the pool, and it shows about ability that a person can swim, but a person can't do, right? Can't do and cannot do. So here, like you can see, but I can swim in the pool, so it shows about ability of a person who can swim. All right, let's go to number two. You can fly. Like you can see here, we have only subject plus can plus verb. We don't have any object. But this sentence, we have subject plus can plus verb, and then plus object, right? So this means that the object. Sometimes we use, sometimes we don't use, like you can see here, subject, and then modal verb, so and then verb base, after that this one is object, and here you can see subject plus can, and then plus verb, we don't have any object, so it is correct, it's true that object we can use, and sometimes we don't use, the sentence still called correct or still complete sentence. Now let's go to number three. My friend can play the guitar. My friend can play the guitar. Like you can see here, can. You can see can here, right? Why verb we don't add S? Because friend is third person singular. Why play we don't add S? As I have mentioned earlier, so when we use modal verb can, we must use with verb base. Verb base means verb don't change form, even the subject is third person singular, but because of the verb can appear between subject and verb here, that is why verb we don't have to add S, right? And can we add S with can because he is third person singular? No, because can is a modal verb, and after modal verb we also don't have to add S too, right? Modal verb can add S. And after modal verb also don't have to add S too. This is about the way how to use modal verb. Alright, now let's go to could. But before I go to the could, teacher would like to talk about number 4 and number 5 here. Why teacher don't write anything? because the teacher would like you to create two more sentences by your own self about how to use can. Alright, let's go to number three. Let's go to could. So could we refer to the activity or refer to what you can do in the past, right? Alright. We could sing well when we were young. For example, now you are adult already, right? Now you are adult already. And you want to say that when we were young, we could sing well. But when we are teenager, we cannot sing because our sound changed, right? Our sound is changed. So our sound is changed. So that's why we cannot sing well, not like when we were young or like we were kids or children, like this. So you can use could. So we could sing well when we were young. Now let's go to number two. She could walk yesterday, but now her legs have problem. So yesterday she could walk, right? She could walk yesterday, but because of today, her leg has problem. Maybe she have the broken leg, or she have an accident. That's why she cannot walk well. Just yesterday she can walk, but now cannot. All right. Let's go to number three. Miley could dance. So here we refer to the activity that Miley could do in the past, right? Could do in the past. Like you can see here, after could, why sing we don't have to use a sang in the past? Because here the time is present in the past. Because like I have mentioned earlier, after modal verb can or could, we cannot use another verb beside verb base, right? Not only can, but even could also the same, because could also the modal verb, but it's just used in the past, right? So sing still sing, walk still walk, we don't have to add ed, and dance still dance, we don't have to add ed. As what? A could is a modal verb, and sing come after could, so we don't have to add anything or change. Alright everyone, I hope that you can understand about this one. And for number 4 until number 5 here, I would like to create the sentences by your own self and also with could the same as can. So if there's any question related to our second session, you can ask your homeroom teacher for more detail. Now our lesson is finished. See you again on Monday everyone. Please have a nice weekend. But at the end, I would like to say that please protect yourself during this time, because the weekend you might feel bored, so you might go somewhere. So when you want to go there, make sure that you wear mask or share mask, and also wash your hand often, or bring hand sanitizer along with you to clean your hand often before after you touch something. All right, so goodbye everyone. See you on Monday and good luck.